In today's lecture, we will discuss white-collar crimes. Coming to the definition to understand the meaning of white-collar crimes. So, as the name suggests, we do have a rough idea about what white-collar jobs are. White-collar jobs are the good jobs, the good-paying jobs in the society. And white-collar crimes are those crimes which are done by those kind of people who belong to a high social status. Now, there's a definition given by Sutherland, and Sutherland is the one who used this term for the first time in 1939. So, Sutherland was a professor of sociology. He used this term and talked about white-collar crimes when he talked about crime and the crimes related to the society. So, in a nutshell, we can say that the deceptive practices that happen for the reasons of financial gains, that is, you are deceiving someone, you are cheating someone in order to gain money out of it. Now, to deepen our understanding, we can say that white-collar crimes can also be known as public welfare offenses or socio-economic crimes. What happens exactly is, there are rules in the society. It can be related to the corporate laws, it can be cyber laws, and so on and so forth. So, when we talk about the laws that are there and when the laws are broken, for example, I am asked to invest in a company and they promise me that they will, return a percentage of it in a certain period of time. After that time, I do not get any money. Even the money that I invested, even that is lost. So, what happens? There is a case of fraud. That means I have been cheated on. And in such kind of cases, in such kind of crimes, the losses are very high because the targets are really big groups. It is not targeted to just one person. Because just imagine if there is a scheme and they are promising you that they will double the money after 6 years. So, a lot of people would think that it is such a compelling scheme and I want to invest in it. So, the target group becomes very, very large. Now, here's a broad classification that what kind of crimes that can be, come under the white collar crimes. So, first is occupational, which happens in professionals. For example, an example can also be harassing your employers. When the employers, they do not, if they are cutting the salary, if they are making them work overtime, even these are kinds of crimes only. Second is corporate crimes that are, done by big companies and businesses. For example, dumping their waste in the rivers and, they are aiding to the pollution. Crimes of the powerful people, for example, politicians. Crimes of the state. Crimes of the state. When there is a human rights violations, when there are something that leads to riots or war crimes, these can be crimes of the state. Now, going back to Sutherland, he defined what is white collar crime and he also gave some of the types of offenses that come under the white collar crimes. For example, selling adulterated goods, selling adulterated food, manipulation in stock exchange, bribery, tax fraud, illegal abortions, illegal sale of alcohol, narcotics, mislabeling of goods, that is also misleading and it is also a crime. There are some others, you can just take a look. Coming to the characteristics of white collar crimes, so these are not the traditional criminals and it is not a traditional crime because the target of victims is very big. The target is very huge. So these are the crimes that are done by people who hold status and power in the society. The methods that can be adopted by them are fraud, misrepresentation, for example, misrepresenting the whole scheme, misrepresenting about their profits perhaps, about the status of the company. Adulteration, that means mixing something in the goods that they are selling so that it is not of the quality that they claim it to be. Irregularity. Irregularity is also a kind of crime only. For example, if a company promises you to give interest for your investment after every 3 months, but the interests are delayed by say 6 months, 9 months, so there is an irregularity and this is also a crime. Now, the nature of these crimes are deliberate and these are planned conspiracies. They are deliberate because they have an intention. They have an intention to earn money by unfair means. So it is not that it happened because of some mistake. No, it was planned and deliberate. These crimes are more tolerant by people of a status because they relate with them. For example, you know, doctors, advocates, bureaucrats at big levels, they are very much familiar with this kind of crime and they are more tolerant towards it. The victims are usually the entire community or the entire society. For example, Nirav Modi case, who borrowed so much money from Punjab National Bank and then he just disappeared. So it has affected the whole society. It is not just the bank that suffered, but the whole society, the whole country did. Another example can be Ponzi schemes. So what are these Ponzi schemes? These are, you know, fraudulent investment schemes where what happens is payment of the original investors, it becomes the fund for the next investors. For example, if I have spent 1 lakh in the scheme today, now they will say that and they promised that this 1 lakh rupees will convert into 2 lakhs in a given period of time. Now what happens? They keep promising high rate of return and it does not exist at all. That return is never going to come to you. And the initial payment that you gave, that is also drowned. It is not coming to you. And what they do is they keep attracting a lot of new investors because of the same thing. And even if they pay you back, it is because of the new investors who has already spent something. So no matter how much you invest, there is always a loss because it is a big scam which is targeted towards people who do not have sufficient knowledge and they fail to understand the real intentions behind such scams. It is also hard to detect because you cannot go through the records of every company and there you cannot keep on investigating whether the company is doing right or not, whether you know what they are promising it is going to happen or not, because sometimes they do it so wisely, they do it so smartly that only an expert with the kind of knowledge can identify this kind of crime. It is also considered less serious, so the police even do not, you know, devote so much time in solving cases like this. But it is important to note that it impacts the social life and it is not easy to curb. For example, it is so difficult to, you know, curb poverty because it is at such a large scale. It is the same with the white collar crimes. So in 1964, the government introduced the Santaram Committee on the Prevention. Some of the suggestions by the Santaram Committee are, they said that first they included what are the felonies that are included under the white collar crimes. It can be smuggling, profiteering, violation of standards, weights, misuse of position and so on and so forth. They also gave some of the suggestions like including administrative, legal, socio-economic and educative measures. That means we have to be strict in implicating the administrative and legal procedures. We have to be very vigilant when it comes to the socio-economic causes and we have to educate people of their rights, of their, you know, especially their legal rights and how they should be more and more aware. There is also a need to study the scope and motivation behind corruption. Why do people do such things anyway? So there is a need to understand this. There is a need to check the existing practices so that we can be prepared for what happens in the future. Also to avoid delays in tackling with such cases. Strict enforcement of rules and laws is very important to take the right stand while trying to eradicate such kind of cases. The codes of conduct of the businesses and firms should be followed religiously. A detailed accounts of expenditure of the company should be maintained and it should be audited. The taxation laws need a lot of modification. Bureaucratic corruption should be reduced. Corruption trials should be fast-tracked and it should be done on a very strict basis. The government also enacted the Prevention of Corruption Act in the year 1947, which was a big fail at that time. But today, with the new government, with the new times, we see a lot of improvement is there. But still, there are many businesses who are still evading tax, and there are a lot of schemes which are scams for the people, and they, play with the sentiments of a lot of people in the society. Now, let us understand and discuss some questions here. First is, what type of a crime is committed by a chartered accountant who manipulates accounts of a business corporation? So see, the word here is business corporation, and the crime that would be here is a white collar crime. So the answer will be C. Next question is, the concepts associated with Sutherland are, so see, we just discussed that he has talked about white collar crime. So the answer 3 is correct. In crime and delinquency, we have also discussed that it was Sutherland who said that crime is learned. So therefore, the answer is option A. Next is, here's an assertion which says it is impossible to know the extent of white collar crime. This is true because, like I said, it is very easy to hide the crimes, the white collar crimes that take place in the business, or that something that happens on a day-to-day basis. For example, they can try to conceal their expenses, and those expenses which the investors are giving them, what the stakeholders are giving them, they can use it as profits. Now, the reason given here is, the extent of white collar crime remains unknown because white collar crime rarely occurs in educated population groups. So this is entirely wrong. This kind of crime is mainly focused, and it is done by the educated population groups who hold power and status in the society. So the answer will be option A. Assertion is correct, but the reason is wrong. I hope you got the lecture. Thank you for watching.